In this video, we're looking at a block and spring problem where this block is sliding with an initial speed of 1.75 meters per second. It has a mass given to us of 2.58 kilograms. We know the stiffness of the spring. It has a spring constant of 28.0 newtons per meter. And we're not dealing with any friction on the surface here. So in part A, we're asked for the maximum compression of the spring during the bounce. And then in part B, for the maximum acceleration of the block during the bounce. So the maximum compression part, that's an energy conservation question. And there's not much going on here. I have initial kinetic energy in this initial state, and there's no energy anywhere else in the problem. And then in the final state, at the point of maximum compression, the block is turning around and it's momentarily stationary there. That's the point where 100% of the kinetic energy has been converted into the potential energy of the spring. So the energy conservation idea here is just that the initial kinetic energy turns into the final spring potential energy. And our initial kinetic energy was 1/2 mv0 squared for the sliding block. And our final spring potential energy when the conversion is complete is 1/2 kx max squared. We can multiply both sides by 2, and we're trying to solve for x max. So we divide by k, then we square root the result. And I end up with the square root of mv0 squared over k. Now we just plug in the numbers. And when we run the numbers on this to 3 significant digits, we get 0.531 meters. And it might look nicer to express that in centimeters. So it's 53.1 centimeters. In part B, we want the maximum acceleration of the block during this bounce. And the key concept here is that the max acceleration occurs when the spring force is maximized. And of course, the spring force is maximized when it's at its maximum compression. So we calculate the force exerted by the spring using Hooke's law. So I don't need to worry about the minus sign. I'm just finding the magnitude of the force right now. So F is equal to Kx. I have the spring constant as 28.0. And then the max compression of the spring, I need to express that in meters, so 0.531. And I get 14.87 newtons for the maximum force experienced by the block. Now there are no other horizontal forces on the block. So applying Newton's second law is very simple here. There's just one force that we're concerned with. I write down A equals F over M, Newton's second law. The force experienced by the block pointing to the left, 14.87 newtons. And the mass of the block, 2.58 kilograms. Into 3 significant digits, I get an acceleration of 5.76 meters per second squared. Again, our interpretation of the question here was that we were looking for a magnitude of the acceleration, but it is pointing to the left. So if you wanted to include a direction, you'd put a minus sign on it. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.